Hey, this is Dr. K from iMedicalSchool, here to talk about the general principles of anemia. In later videos, we will focus on the causes of anemia and then differentiate different types, but for now, let's focus on the basics. Now, it's important to understand the basics of anemia before jumping in how to differentiate between anemias. So let's first begin by talking about what is anemia. Anemia is described as a low hemoglobin, hematocrit, or RBC mass. Which measure of blood levels you use will really depend on the culture at your hospital. I will generally talk about hemoglobin. Now, hemoglobin measures the amount of oxygen-carrying pigment that is present in the red blood cell. The pigment is hemoglobin. Other measures of the blood include hematocrit and RBC mass. Hematocrit measures the percentage of the volume of whole blood that is made up of red blood cells. Finally, red blood cell mass is defined as the number of red blood cells in a given defined volume. Now that we know hemoglobin, hematocrit, and RBC mass are measures of how much blood we have, let's talk about the life of a red blood cell. The body is able to recognize when there's not an adequate amount of red blood cells present. In order to increase the number of red blood cells, the kidney releases a hormone called EPO, or erythropoietin. EPO was made famous by many athletes who used it to increase the number of RBCs they had, as to have a better oxygen-carrying capacity, and essentially improve their endurance. Now, EPO tells the bone marrow to produce what are called erythroid burst-forming units, or BFUEs, and erythroid colony-forming units, or CFUEs. These cells convert to normal blasts, which expel their nucleus. The loss of the nucleus allows for the biconcave shape RBCs have. This biconcave shape is very important because it allows RBCs to bend and fit through very small vessels to provide oxygen to your peripheral tissues. These new cells are called reticulocytes. The reticulocytes are noticeable because they contain a visible ribosomal network to produce proteins. Remember, ribosomes are enzymes that are involved in translation of RNA into proteins. Reticulocytes spend about 3 days in the bone marrow and 1 day in the bloodstream before they mature to RBCs by getting rid of the ribosomal network. Once in circulation, as mature red blood cells, they have a lifespan of about 120 days. Old RBCs are filtered out by the spleen and are destroyed. Now, anemia is when you have low blood levels. We define anemia as a hemoglobin less than 12 for women and 13 for men. Let's talk about how someone can develop an anemia. There are only three ways to develop a low blood count. Your bone marrow is not making enough to replace the old red blood cells. You're losing them through destruction called hemolysis, or you're bleeding. Understanding how to differentiate these three processes is very important. We'll talk about how to evaluate anemia and the specific types of anemia in our next video. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give this video a like, comment if you have any questions or comments, share this video with your friends on Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Pinterest, Tumblr, and so much more, and finally subscribe. You can follow us on Twitter at iMedSchool and Facebook and Google+ at iMedicalSchool. This is Dr. K, and I'll see you next time.